In last week's video, I talked about the importance of an emergency fund, and many of you wanted to know, well, how do I figure out what 3 to 6 months of my living expenses are? Well, that's an excellent question. And in today's video, you're going to find out that and much more using what I like to call the playbook. What's up, guys? It's John Schuller again, back with John Schuller Consulting. In today's video, I'm going to talk about the budget book, aka what I like to call a playbook. Guys, and excuse my cheesy sports reference here, but you're not going to win the game of finance without a playbook. And so that's what I have right here. My wife and I have been using this for several years now. It's coached amongst a lot of financial consultants, and I love it. I think it's a critical part of starting your wealth building process. So what you're going to want to do is go out, spend a dollar. Yes, you have my permission to spend a dollar because it's an investment. And you're going to get just this, a notebook. And on the front of it, you can write budget book, or you can do like I do and write playbook and write 2018 on the front of it, or whatever year it is. And this is just a general book. I just made up these numbers to give you guys an idea. So once you get the book, at the top of the first page, you're going to write the month. So if you're starting this in September, it'll look like this, September 2019. Then from there, you're just going to simply write your in and your out. Guys, budgeting is simple math. You just want more coming in than is going out. But with the way everything is set up these days with direct deposit and auto withdrawal and subscription based, we have no idea what's going in and out of our account. Even our paychecks are direct deposited. So it makes it really hard to manage that. And I know they make apps, guys, but an app also doesn't keep you accountable. You don't have to check it, you don't have to look at it. But with this budget book or this playbook, you have to write every single thing down that you spend or that comes in. And that holds you accountable and lets you know exactly where you're at the end of the month. Also, when you go out to dinner 3 times in a row that week and you spend $40, $50 on a dinner and you write that down every time, that's going to trigger your brain, or hopefully it should, to be like, hey, I'm probably eating out too many times. But if you're just using your debit card or your credit card and not looking at it again till the end of the month or ever, it's not going to hold you accountable for those purchases. So that's why I love keeping this budget book around. So to find out your emergency expense cost, you're going to add up everything you spend in a month and basically multiply it by 3 or by 6. It's that simple. So if it's $2,000, that is $6,000 that you need to last you 3 months. And you want to put that cash in a savings account or somewhere that is very liquid. You don't want to tie this up in stocks or in bonds like I mentioned before. You just want to put it in a savings account, probably making 0.5% interest a year if you're lucky. So that's what you want to do. That's how you figure out that. What you also do with this budget book is it teaches you what you're spending money on that you don't need to be, or just where your money's going, really. So at the end of the month, I like to do this. I've even fine-tuned this process, or Rihanna and I have. And what we do is we break it down by category. We have bills, we have retirement, we have food, we have auto, and we break this all down. So that way, at the end of the month, we know exactly where our money's going, right? And it's not, everything's just not going wherever. We categorize it, and then at the end of the month, we can say, well, hey, we spent this much on auto, or this much on retirement, or this much on bills, and is there something we can do to adjust that for next month? And that's why I call it the playbook, because it lets you know the next play or the next move that you should make going forward to better adjust your finances for success. So guys, get you one of these books, write down every single thing that comes in, every single thing that goes out. At the end of the month, if your net is negative, you have a problem, especially if that happens for several months. If your net is positive, great, but how can you expand on that? How can you make it even better? Or how can you take that positive money, put it to retirement, and then plan for your future? That's why I love a playbook. That's why I love a budget book. It's the first thing I have my clients do. I know it can sound boring or tedious, but that's good. That's what we want to do. This is super simple, guys. This isn't magic tricks or anything like that. There's nothing super exciting about this. But there is something super exciting about retiring with millions of dollars. Do this tedious stuff, maintain the self-discipline, and you guys will reach your goals. All right, guys, I hope that helps. If you have any more questions or any other videos you'd like me to make, please suggest them below. I really appreciate you guys watching, and I'll see you on the next video.